Welcome to Unlocking SuiteCommerce, a series of tutorials, how-tos, and guides guaranteed to make SuiteCommerce easy. Hi, I'm Fran, Project Management Officer at Tavano Team, and today I'm going to show you how to set up the Request a Quote feature in SuiteCommerce. Request a Quote is a SuiteCommerce feature that lets users ask for a custom quote directly to the merchant right from their profile. There are two ways of creating a quote, from the product detail page or from the Request a Quote page. Let's start with the product page. If the Request a Quote feature is available, users will see two call to action buttons on the product page, Add to Cart and Add to Quote. The Add to Quote button lets users create a custom quote request. Quotes are related to registered users, so you will need to be logged in to create and access a quote. When they click on Add to Quote, the item will be added to an existing quote, and if there's not one, a new one will be created. By clicking on the link below, they'll be taken to the quote, now including the item they just selected. Inside the quote, they can add more items too. In this case, they'll use the Quick Add feature I talked about in another video. Click the link on your screen to watch the full tutorial on Quick Add feature for SuiteCommerce. Users can also add custom messages, for example, requesting for more information or asking for special pricing based on volume. When the user submits the quote, they'll see a message confirming that the item has been added to the quote request. This message can be customized. After the user submits the quote, the merchant will have the quote available as an estimate on the spot. Once the quote has been submitted, the user cannot make changes to it. A quicker, simpler, and more straightforward way to create a quote request is from the navigation menu. Click on the Request a Quote link on the menu and you will be taken to the Quotes page showing all of the quotes that you have submitted. With a Quick Add feature, users can start adding items to their quote requests. Users can have more than one quote going on at the same time. This is particularly useful for some industries, such as contractors and companies that act as intermediaries for other customers. Also, they can download a PDF version of the quote for their records. From the NetSuite UI, merchants will see quote name as estimates. Don't worry, they're the same thing. Go to Transactions, Sales, Prepare Estimates, Lists, find your estimate there, and in the Communication tab, you can see the user's comments, reply to them, and leave new messages for them. If you approve the quote, the user will see that the quote is cleared to proceed with the purchase. To approve it, the status needs to be updated. Each account can have a specific approval status. To set yours, go to the configuration record. Go to Commerce, Websites, Configuration. Select your website and the domain. Find the My Account tab, and in the Quote subtab, you'll find the Purchase Ready Status ID field. Make sure to set the internal ID of the status you want to use. Here is also where you can customize all of the messages related to this feature. After you change the status, the customer will now see the Proceed to Checkout with a Quote button. Note that the user will not be able to apply a quote to a purchase unless approved by the merchant. Once approved, they will be able to proceed to checkout. Not all customers can submit quotes. They need to be granted the necessary permissions. If they don't have permissions, they'll see this message. To grant them permission, navigate to Setup, Users and Roles, Manage Roles. Click on Customize next to the Customer Center role or whichever role you're using for the website. On the Transactions subtab, change the level of access for the Estimate to Create. You can set up the same access by default for every new customer, or you can create two roles, one with access to quotes and one without. And that's it. Now you're ready to set up the Request a Quote feature in your SuiteCommerce website yourself. Give it a try. Subscribe to our channel for more SuiteCommerce tutorials and don't forget to turn on the notifications. See you next time.